seeing some together, but today I got Esther going. So we don't have time. And also, there are two chapters, chapter 14, 15, more than 80 questions. So we just focus on the story of heaven. 14:6-15. Let's read one verse, one by one. And the people of Judah came to Joshua and Gilgal, and Caleb the son of Jephunneh the Canaanite said to him, "You know what the Lord said to Moses, the Meribah, in Kadesh Barnea, concerning you and me.
I was 40 years old when Moses, the servant of the Lord, sent me from the Kadesh Barnea to spy out the land of the land, and I brought him word again as it was in my heart.
But my brothers who went up with me made the heart of the people melt. Yet I will follow the Lord my God, the Moses swore.
Joshua chapter 1 tells us that Joshua, he became successor after Moses. And God commanded, "Be strong and be courageous. I will be with you." And Joshua, he became leader for Israel. Then chapter 2 to chapter 13. Actually chapter 2 13. Chapter 2 to chapter 13. So God promised Israel you can possess the land of Canaan, and the people of Israel, they possess the land of Canaan, and they fight to possess this land. Then, chapter 14 to 21, after they possess Canaan, they allot it. They share, they distribute the land. Judah and the other twelve tribes, they distribute the land of Canaan. So, chapter 14 to 21, the most chapter describing this part belong to Judah, this part belong to the Manasseh. A lot of names of Canaan. That's the major screaming in these chapters. So maybe you feel very going on. A lot of names of Canaan. But that's very important. Why? Name name of cities and some part in the Canaan. No, this is the evidence, very historical evidence. God promised you would possess like a Songsaeng, Namyeongju, then when the people see the record, the name of the Canaan, this is the history. God surely fulfilled His promise in the history. This is very clear evidence of God's promise fulfilled. Then from chapter 14, we can see how the tribe of Israel, 12 tribes, allot inheritance south, the west, east of Canaan. So chapter 14, verse 1 through 5. These verses tell us the west of the Jordan. So the people of Israel, they share the western part of Jordan for their inheritances. And also 15, whole chapter 15, this is the story of allotment of Judah. And today, a lot of story, but we just focus on is 14, 6 to 15, and 15, 13 to 19. This is the story of faith of Caleb. Actually, Caleb is the man of faith. His character is faith, very faithful. That's what Caleb means. Do you remember the meaning? The Caleb? Animal. Dog. Dog. Dog is, cat is very faithful. Right? So he is very man of faith. And faithful means actually full of faith. Full faith. His character is very faithful. Full of we see his page and what is the instruction from the stoic Keller. We read 14, 6 to 15. And Keller, he is now very old. How old? Verse 10 says, behold, I am this day. How many years? How long? 85 years. How was it? He's old man. But he says, verse 12, so now give me this hill country of which the Lord spoke on that day. For you heard on that day how the Anakim were there with great fortified cities. It may be that the Lord will be with me, and I shall drive them out, just as the Lord said. What does it mean? Caleb, he says, I'm still strong. I have a great hair, and he's old man. I'm 85 years old, but I'm still strong. If God is with me, I can fight. I can still fight. Can you do that 85 years? You know, God promised Canaan as an inheritance of Israel. Right? God promised Israel they will get Canaan. God promised. But you remember last Sunday I preached about that. God, even though God promised something, if we trust God's promise, we more active. We become active. Not just watching, waiting. Even though God promised Israel, you enter this land, you possess, then what do they do? They fight. They must possess this land by fighting war. And then Joshua, Israelite, including Caleb, they went to war against the people in Canaan. They need to fight. And now they almost win the land of Canaan. They still have a war, but they need to fight continually to inherit the promised land, the Canaan. And Caleb, he says, God promised we will drive the people of Canaan out. Then I still have strength, and I will do that. We can guess some curious. Well, maybe you think Israel, they enter Canaan and then maybe just quickly inherit this land, but not quickly. Can you guess how many years? Verse 7, 9, 10, we can guess. He says, I was 40 years old when Moses, the servant of the Lord, sent me from Kadesh-Barnea to spy out the land. He says, when he was 40 years old, you remember? Joshua, Caleb, they spied out then in Transylvania, most spies, they report negatively, right? 12 spies, they went to the Canaan, and 10 spies, they said, we are lack of food for the people in Canaan. Do you remember? We are like a very small compared to the people in Canaan. They are like a giant. We go there, we will die. But only Joshua, Caleb, they said, we can possess this land because God promised. That's the place of Kadesh Barnea. And then, verse 10. Verse 9 says, He fully followed the Lord my God. And verse 10, and now, behold, the Lord has kept me alive. Just he has said, this, how many years? 45 years since the time that the Lord spoke his word to Moses. And while Israel walked in the wilderness. 45 years. Since he spied out the land of Canaan. The time passed by, and how many years? 45 years. And Israel, they are in the wilderness how many years? Wilderness in the wilderness, 40 years. So, at least 5 years. Because 40 years in the wilderness, they will die. All the generation, they will die. Now, mesometic. Now you are very sleepy. What I mean is, even though God promised they enter this kingdom, almost 5 years they are fighting to possess this land. Not very faster. 5 years they need fight. And then this Caleb says, now I'm 85 years old. Maybe he said, oh, I'm old, I want to stop fighting. But he said, no, I'm still strong. God still is with me, and I believe God's promise. He said, because Lord spoken. And he said, what does it mean? About 45 years old, before God, he promised, we Israelites, we will enter and possess this land. He remembered God's promise. He never forget God's promise. Almost 45 years old, he never forget God's promise, and he's still believing God's promise. And then, even now, I'm old, but I can fight, and you just command me, I will drive the people in Canaan out. Maybe you don't know this song, but we Korean. Most of Korean Christian, we love this song, the song of Caleb. Actually, verse 12. So now give me this hill country of which the Lord spoke on that day. He says, you give me this hill country, he will fight to inhabit this hill country. get his land, his country. Because his hill country is also the God's spoke on that day, almost 45 years ago, 45 years before. Well, you heard that day how the Anakim were there with the great 45 cities. It may be that the Lord will be with me, and I will drive them out, just as the Lord says. If God is with me, I can fight still, and I will surely drive out them. And then, if you see the 15, 13 to 19, Joshua, he heard Caleb, he can still fight. Then 13 to 19, Joshua, he allowed Caleb fight. And he gets the God promise. But on the contrary, chapter 15, 30, 63, there's a sad story. 1563, but the Jebusite, the inhabitants of Jerusalem, the people of Judah could not drive out. So the Jebusite were with the people of Judah and Jerusalem. Even though God promised the land of Canaan, they must fight to get their portion. Judah, their mistake is they didn't fight and try. And then, until now, the Jebusites, actually they must drive his tribe, but because they didn't obey God's promise and God's command, his Jebusites people, they live with them and they become like a hindrance, obstacles of their life. They also fight, but they obey not 100%, maybe like a 90%. And we people of God, we heard and we know that the God's promise in the Bible, a lot of promise for our life, our future, and our soul, and a lot of promises of God. And in our life, a lot of like a hill countries, a lot of mountains, a lot of things we have to fight. Even though God promised some blessing, we must be active to possess the benefit and blessing of God by faith, like a Caleb. He didn't stop. He still trusting, and he fight, and he got his portion. And verse 15 is very meaningful. Now the name of Hebron formerly was hear Alba. Alba was the greatest man among the Anakin. And last sentence is good. Last sentence is what? The land has its own home. The land has less from the world. This is irony. The land that blessed me does not mean there is no war. Why? Later we see the Caleb fight, still war. But the Bible says the land had less of the war. Actually, this last means like a shalom, shalom. Shalom. Shalom means peace. Peace. Full of peace. But in reality, there's still war. But the Bible says, the land had blessed from the world. What does it mean? The Israel, Caleb, Joshua, they're still in the war. But because of Caleb, 14 says, therefore Israel became the inheritors of Caleb, the son of. And then, because he fully followed the Lord, the God of Israel. Then the Bible says, now, the land has blessed from the Lord. Like a fellow, he's still in the war, he must fight still, but because of his faith, Like Ellen still have a lot of problem, he must fight, have a lot of enemies there in your life, but if you have a full of faith, in spite of a lot of obstacles and enemies in your life, you have a peace. Not because there's no enemies, not because there's no a lot of obstacles. A lot of obstacles and enemies still in our life. But if we have full of faith like a pillar, our life is like a Shalom. Father, thank you for your presence this morning with your children. We see what is the faithful and faith to your promise from your word. We are not great, but you are great. And faith in your greatness brings true peace and shalom in our life. We still have a lot of problems, a lot of crises, afflictions, agonies, sufferings. We must fight still for the Lord. If you are still with us, and we can trust your promise for our ultimate victory in our life. We have a peace and we have a comfort. And our enemies and our obstacles, they cannot break our peace. in you. Lord, you bless my brothers and sisters this morning. Their life is like a fight and battle, war. And they must work hard. And family matters, and sickness, stress, a lot of hindrances there in their life. But you let them be like a Caleb, the man of faith, fully follow and trust your promise. Then they may see true peace, true shalom in their life. You are there. Since you are God of them, when they are saved by your grace, you are still our Lord. You are still our God. And you will be our God to the end of the age. And you also give the peace to family back home in Philippines. A lot of troubles there. But you make the family of our members strong in faith in your promise, and you grant them peace in their life, in their troubles. You never change and cancel your promise, but instead you surely fulfill, accomplish your promise. But we don't want to be lazy, but we want to be active, to obey and possess what you have spoken to us. In Jesus' name I pray.